But I picked the right day to try and do a bit of plein air painting. Absolutely pouring down. I'm sat in the boot of the car. Hopefully the door was acting as a roof to keep the rain off. So hopefully I'll get away with it and I won't get too much water, too much rain on the paper. But going into Rossia now. Straight the way across. Bring that right down to the bottom. Clean brush. And then I'm going into ultramarine. Ultramarine, just going to say. Well, because it's such a miserable looking day, I'm going to put a bit of Payne's grey with it. And then bring that down into the water area, which is going to be along here. I always like to get it in first while I've still got the paint on the brush. So that's the sky. So next I'm going to do the distant trees. So I'm going back into Russia now, mixing the same three colours together basically. Payne's grey, ultramarine, raw sienna, and then just constantly varying it as I'm going across. A bit of lemon yellow as well. Raw sienna. Maybe even a bit of burnt umber as well, just a bit. A bit varying the flavour. And just make them a little bit bigger over on this right hand side. Just to, you don't want them all the same height, just makes them look a bit boring. Now I can also see some grassy areas, so I'm just going to go just purely like a bit of raw sienna and a bit of lemon yellow just to suggest these grassy areas that I can see. And then while the paint's still wet, but what I'll do, some bigger trees than that. So I'm going to go ultramarine, burnt umber, a bit of ultramarine, pretty dark mix, and then somewhere up there, and a bigger one, and then another one next to him over on this, just to the right of it, and then just get my fingernail. Don't overdo it, it's so easy to overdo it, but try and keep it as subtle as you can. Obviously the problem with outdoors, I haven't got my hair dryer, so I have to wait for it to dry naturally. I can see it's just flecks of rain on there, but I'm just going to plow on regardless of it. Next thing I'm going to do, I can't put the reflections in it because I've got to wait for that to dry. What I can do, if I just make sure, nice dry brush, chisel edge, and then just get like a darkish mix, and I'll put some fence, suggest some fence posts over on that far side. There's a fence or the like, dead just branches lying on the floor. a few muddy areas over on the far bank. Bits of reeds and what have you. It's the areas where the ducks like to hide. While I'm waiting for that to dry, that water area, I'm going to move on to this foreground. So it's raw sienna, burnt umber, ultramarine, just mix them all together. Nice darkish mix. And then there's lots of broken branches and what have you. You can use a rigger for this if you like. I'm just doing it for convenience with a hike. It's a very versatile brush. So obviously the problem there is I'm going to be able to put the reflections in very well because I've come over into the water area. But never mind. So I just like to put in, just start it off with the hike, and then switch to the rigger, same colours, raw sienna, burnt umber, ultramarine, plenty of water, and then just work these around. And then if I take the switch back to the hike, clean brush, if I just scuff the ends up like so, and I can just suggest all the little twigs and branches, just nice and dry, and then just dip in like that, and then you can